Hello, my lovely audience. Welcome to today's episode of Time with Your Beloved Midwife, Kenneth. Hi, I am glad that we've met again to continue our discussion on the reproductive system. We drew the curtains on the male reproductive system during our last episode. And so today, we are moving straight into the female reproductive system. If you missed out on any of the episodes concerning the male reproductive system, kindly visit the videos and to get yourself updated. Thank you. To be part of this beautiful family where we learn together, have fun, vibe and promote our health, you already know what to do. Kindly subscribe to the channel, like and share the videos, leave your comments, tap on the notification bell and click on the video card. Mwah! To the topic for discussion, the female reproductive system. When I think of the female reproductive system, only two things comes into mind. First, me. I am a female. And second, a fab. Assigned female at birth. And so a midwife assigned me as a female because of certain organs or characteristics I possessed when I was being pushed out from my mother's vagina. And so today, I am celebrating myself. I am celebrating all the females. Female reproductive system is the body part that help women assigned female at birth. The female reproductive system is made up of both internal and external sex organs, just as the male reproductive system. And these organs, they function collectively in the reproduction of new offspring. And so, you should also remember that when we're talking about the male reproductive system, I made mention that it is only the reproductive system that does not function until puberty. The female reproductive system is immature at birth and develops to maturity at puberty. Again, at puberty, to be able to produce gametes and to carry a fetus to full term. That is how come I always advocate against teenage pregnancy. Because during that stage, you are a teenager, you are in your puberty stage. Your female reproductive system is now growing, it's now maturing. And so if you get pregnant, you would rather predispose yourself to health complications. And if you don't take care, you are likely to either lose your child or lose your life. And so please, let all advocate against teenage pregnancy. One will ask, then when is the right time to give birth? Please, maybe within the ages of 24 upwards. Then your reproductive system is matured enough to accommodate a visitor, and the visitor here is their fetus. Thank you. The functions of the female reproductive system. Oh yes, in summary, let me just say, the female reproductive system makes reproduction possible, makes pregnancy possible, and childbirth also possible. But that's so vague. Let me break it down. And so the functions of the female reproductive system. The female reproductive system produces the female sex cells known as the gametes, also called what? Eggs, right? And these eggs makes reproduction possible. And so it answers that. It also secretes the sex hormones, including estrogen and progesterone. It is these same sex hormones that makes ovulation possible, that makes menstruation possible, that even makes the production of this breast milk we always talk about, yeah, also possible. And so you see, it does a whole lot of things. You can't take it for granted. The female reproductive system provides a site for fertilization. And it also enables a gestation of the fetus if fertilization occurs. The same female reproductive system enables childbirth. Yeah. Don't worry, all these things we move into detail so you get to understand it well, alright? Because all the various reproductive organs play a role in making these possible. And so you get to understand them when we move into details. And so, these are the functions of the female reproductive system. When I was talking about the female reproductive system, I made mention that it's also made up of internal and external organs, just as the male reproductive system. There are a lot of similarities, yeah? So they do almost the same thing, just that their names are different. Just that. And so when we take the external sex organs or the external genital organs, we would discover that there is something called a vulva. vulva. Yes, vulva. And that is the collective name. So in the vulva, you would get to hear the labia majora, the labia minora, the clitoris, the vestibule. And inside the vestibule, there are six openings. And here we will discover the urethral meatus, the two skinny ducts, the vaginal orifice. We have the two Bartholin's ducts and the glands. You will discover all that. Do you know what is called hymen? Ah, we will discover that too. This is an interesting topic indeed. So these are the external organs. And when we get into the internal organs, we will discover the vagina. Do you know the difference between... No, let me not go there. But do you know what the vagina is? We will discover that. We will discover. I know why I'm saying that, and those who know why I am saying that too. The cervix, the uterus, the ovaries, and the fallopian tubes. Oh yes. So these are the things we will be considering when we get into details. So this is all about the female reproductive system. I will one day or soon start to reproduce because of my female reproductive system. Already I ovulate and I menstruate. Same way most women menstruate and ovulate. I'm saying most women because this same female reproductive system also makes what? Menopause possible. So we'll get to discuss all that. You see, it's an interesting topic for discussion. And so just get yourself ready for me so that we get to discover all these and appreciate nature in as much as we are learning. This is all for today's episode. We shall meet again to take these organs one by one and discuss. Thank you very much for your love, for your time. Thank you so much for always making it up to my channel. And thank you for introducing more people to my channel. I'm so grateful. I love you all. Continue to promote your health. Continue to take good care of yourselves. And continue to love me because I will forever love you all. Mwah! Take care. Bye.